Thank you, Senator. Thank you, Commissioner. First of all, I want to thank you for your service to the state and the work that you do on behalf of the state every single day. I want to recognize what I feel is a very strong commitment by the governor in this proposed budget for infrastructure improvements across the state to the tune of $15 billion, along with some of the legislation that we passed last year that you've already alluded to. It's going to go a long way to helping infrastructure improvements across the state. Looking forward to working with your office to make sure that happens. I want to go back to what Senator Fuscillo has already mentioned. The Region 5, you and I have been going back and forth via letters and whatnot over the course of the last year regarding this issue, this funding shortfall that occurred back in 2008-2009 out in Region 5. And just to set the tone a little bit, as you know, the historic average has been about 9.9, at least over the course of the last 33 years. Not just for planning purposes, as you had mentioned, but letting totals that came out of the DOT show that in 08-09, that letting total was 4.4%, which was the lowest in the history of the numbers, at least that I have, 32 years. You know, we've been talking about this, and you know, this is something that's extraordinarily important to the region. Region 5 is Niagara County, Erie County, Cattaraugus, and Chautauqua County. You know, our roads and bridges are crumbling. There are 17 highly deficient bridges within Region 5, 12 within Erie County alone that need serious attention. And I just wanted to, I know you alluded to it already, but if you could just talk a little bit about what the DOT has done to fix the mistake that has been admitted. And I also want to mention, you weren't a part of that decision. This was not under this administration. This was not under your leadership. But there was a mistake that the DOT has admitted to that has had catastrophic impacts on the infrastructure in Region 5. And I'd just like to know what the DOT has done thus far.
First, I want to pick up on your point that you mentioned in the governor's commitment to infrastructure investments across the state. And also investments in Buffalo and Western New York, and then I'll respond to the to your specific question. I think, as you're very well aware, and I am very well aware because I was on the committee that reviewed the regional economic plans, Western New York received $104 million in investments under that. And additionally, the governor's budget includes $1 billion for economic development in Buffalo, which is a huge initiative for Buffalo. And I think that needs to be put into the dialogue and into the mix when we talk about what's being done in Western New York. Specific to your question about the $167 million in a mistake, there was not a mistake made from my perspective. What is passed is passed. In infrastructure investment, and particularly in transportation, and there have been lots of conversations going on in Washington, there has been the discussion of needs and wants. And we really need to focus on what the needs are, which is what our capital planning initiative is. We look at the system. We look at making investments efficiently. We look at the return on the investment, and we look at sustainability. We have set targets across the state, and that is the direction we are headed in to make sure that the improvements in our infrastructure continue.
Thank you. I just have to go back to, you stated that there was no mistake made. It was actually at this budget hearing 1 year ago that Stanley G. Testified, not just once but twice, that there was an error that was made, that there was a mistake that was made. Again, this is back in 2008, not under your leadership within the DOT, under a different leadership, under a different governor, but there was a mistake that was made in 08. I recognize the need to move forward. I want to move forward. I think this issue and those that have been advocating for a resolution and a resolve to this issue want to move forward. But they want to make sure that the funding that was taken away from Region 5 in 2008, 2009, that had an impact, estimated at $167 million when you factor in the federal funding that was also put forward through the formula that we were told last year was flawed. So I first of all, just to go back, you know, I'd like to know, moving forward, because we all want to move forward, what we can do together to rectify this. Just moving up the percentages to the historical average, that's good. That's a great start. But there's still a hole that exists in funding that was left out of Region 5, where recently, and I sent this to you this past week, some testimony from the leadership out in Western New York. I don't know if, have you seen the letter? Okay, I have a copy of it here for you that I'll leave you with. But I held a round table on this issue to demonstrate this isn't just us here in Albany talking about this in numbers and equations and math and errors and in percentages and formulas. This is a true, real impact on the ground in Western New York in Region 5. Businesses that had to lay off workers amidst the highest, amidst the construction season when they should have the highest amount of workers, they're laying people off. Businesses that do the design and construction no longer doing design and construction, design work because the county, Erie County, for one, has tabled, shelved, in their words, 23 different bridge projects based upon the fact that in 2008 the funding wasn't appropriated correctly. In Cattaraugus County, Joe Pelletier, the commissioner of Department of Public Works, spoke to the fact that they are rerouting public safety vehicles, fire trucks for that matter, because the load-bearing bridges can't handle the weight of the fire truck, so if someone's house starts on fire or someone's in need of first aid, it's going to take longer for the fire trucks to get around to get to that individual in need. These are real needs. It's a true impact on the quality of life of the people of Western New York, on public safety, on the infrastructure, and again, not done under your leadership. However, I do want to come to a conclusion on this. I do want to come to some kind of resolution where we can right the wrongs of the past. You know, we've been talking about this since you came before us last year. I know that Stanley G had talked about the fact that new formulas were going to be put forward for 2012, 2013. If you could talk maybe about the formulas. Have those formulas been put forward, the new formulas as well?
Excuse me a minute. Is your clock working over there by any chance? Let me just show you this one. Go ahead, answer the question, sir.
You ran out of time.
Okay.
I'm glad that you recognize, as Governor Cuomo does, the impact of not having investments in infrastructure on both the engineering and construction industry. Across the state, the construction industry has experienced a 30% unemployment rate, which is why the governor is proposing to accelerate $1.7 billion worth of projects across the state. As I mentioned in my testimony, the new capital planning initiative of a preservation first agenda, we looked at all of the state system, the pavement, the bridge conditions. We have set targets so that we can maintain a state of good repair and slow down the disinvestment that has happened statewide over the last several years. The planning targets that we put out to the regions are planning targets just for that purpose. Goal number one is to make the low-cost investments to meet those preservation targets. Goal number two is to make wise investments in projects beyond preservation that spur economic development.